everyone, welcome again to my channel. Today we are making potato curry masala. You can use it for any type of dip, like for your puris or even for your dosas. It's a great dip to have. Let's see how we can make it in our kitchen so easy and so fast. Let's go. Okay, over here I have the boiled potatoes. I'm just going to go ahead and peel them, but after that we have the freshly cut and chopped onions. We have cilantro leaves, salt, curry leaves. These are fennel seeds, but you can also use cumin seeds, mustard seeds, urad dal, turmeric powder, oil, and green chilies. And I also have my water over here and my pan and my ladle. So I'll be back after I go and peel that. But before that, I'm just going to show how easy it is to go ahead and peel it. You can also use a peeler, but it's easy for me to do it in my hand because I can do it fast. And I'll be back. Okay, so let's get started. My potatoes are very well peeled. Okay, I have turned on my heat and I just poured in my oil a little bit here over here. And now I'm just waiting for that to get a little warm, and then I'm going to add my mustard seeds, and then I'm going to add my urad dal. Okay, it is ready. Okay, you have to stay back as it can sputter really fast if you are really new to the Indian type of cooking. So now that you can see our mustard seeds sputtering, now is the time to add the urad dal over here. And I'm just going to fry the urad dal until it's golden brown before we add our other ingredients. Okay, as you can see, it's sputtering and my urad dal is medium brown. Now it's time to add the fennel seeds. And I'm going to add my curry leaves. It's kind of sputtered because the curry leaves is a little moist. Right now it can turn into a medium heat right now. And now I'm going to add my chili. And the next thing is the onions. But before that, you want to make sure your curry leaf is very well roasted. And now I'm going to add the onions. The reason why we added fennel seeds instead of cumin seeds is fennel seeds are like a mouth freshener, and they also have a lot of benefits towards the digestion as well. For people who cannot handle potatoes because of the heavy starch, they can add the fennel seeds, so it's going to balance it out in your tummy and it's definitely going to help you aid in digestion. As always, our onion has to be glassy, so we can move on to our next ingredient. Meanwhile, while it's cooking, I'm just going to go ahead and mash my potatoes. I have a masher over here, but you just have to be careful because it may just skip. So I'm just doing it on the top. You never wanted to puree that, you just wanted to see some pieces over here, because once we are going to add water and boil it again one more time a little bit, so it is just going to blend right in. Right, it is done. And let's check on our onion. Alright, my onion is really glassy over here, and oh gosh, I love the aroma and it looks so colorful too. Now is the time to add your turmeric. I like to fry my turmeric a little bit so it doesn't give me that plain raw smell or raw taste. And I'm just going to pour my mashed potatoes. You can even mash it a little bit in your hand if you're not too sure. I'm just going to pour it in. Okay, I went ahead and washed my hand. Now I'm clean. And because I don't like the mashing in my hand, so I have to go get it all cleaned up. So now, if you can look at it, just fry a little bit. Let it all blend together and mix very well. And you can even cut it into small pieces if you don't want a big potato kind. And now it's time to add our plain or distilled water. now let it boil. Now it's on high heat. Let it boil for like another 5 minutes. Okay, I'm just going to close it with a lid and let it boil for like 10 to 15 minutes. And here is another tip. Why do we use a lid? We can just let it go, right? But there are two reasons why. One is the aroma not spreading all over your house and give you a different taste or smell over there. Next thing is when you close the lid, you save a lot of energy in terms of heat because it cooks faster. Okay, now I'm gonna remove my lid and wow, it's cooking very nice. And you just wanna occasionally stir it so it doesn't go to the bottom and burn it or get sticky. So it is ready. Now it's time to add my salt. For this recipe, I'm adding salt in the end. You don't want it to be too salty. If you add it in between, it's gonna be very salty. But we're just going to let it boil for another 2 minutes and then I'm going to add my garnishing with cilantros. And I'm just going to go ahead and close it one more time. Okay, it's ready. And now I'm just going to turn off my heat. And I'm just gonna let it cool a little bit very shortly. So as you can see all these chunks, the potato chunks over here. So this is how it is made. This is a potato curry masala. But if you don't like the chunks, you can still smash it and make it even smaller, or smash it all about and make it a little thick kind of masala soup. But over here, because we are going to eat it with our puris, it's better that it is a little soggy, because puri is like a hard surface, a hard texture. So this will go very well with that. And at this time, I'm just going to add my cilantro. I'm just going to season it very well. And you can always close the lid, but the one thing to notice is if you close this lid for a little longer and when you remove it, it's just going to get all the water in that and it's not gonna look good. So that's why I'm gonna transfer into my bowl. There you go. And that's it, our potato curry masala is ready. And
I'm eating potato curry masala and it is so good. There's a lot of good spices here, and the most notable one that I can taste, which isn't really a spice, is cilantro on the top, and it is so good when you mix it. This, we have rice in this bowl, and it goes together really, really well with...
Eat with rice. We usually eat it with puris, but you wanted to do it with rice today.
Oh, it's very, very good. It kind of soaks up the flavor. And so it's not so soupy, but it's still moist.
Yeah,
it's not drying it up.
It's a curry, so it goes very well with anything as you please, yeah?
Yeah, it's very flavorful, very textured too, and it's very bright. I like that it's so pretty. Your food should also be pretty.
I'm glad you like it.
I do, I like it so much. Thank you, Priya.
It's getting ready to go as a side dish along with our puris. And if you don't know how to make puris, please do watch my videos about our millet puris and many different puris that we have on our playlist under rotis, prathas, and puris. If you like this video, please do subscribe to my channel.